8 weird foreign plumbing facts you didn't know. I think it's funny, you've got a toilet and a bidet so you can relieve yourself and really clean yourself right there while enjoying such a beautiful view from the 154th floor. In this video, we're gonna talk about 8 weird foreign plumbing facts that I bet you didn't know. Some of these I didn't even know. Now, this video is sponsored by The Trade Talks. What I'm asking you to do today is either subscribe to Roger Wakefield if you haven't, or go over to our other channel, The Trade Talks, and subscribe there, where we've got new videos coming out soon. Now, if you haven't seen our other videos about strange plumbing that we found outside the United States, you may jump into the channel and check out those too. Some of these are pretty interesting. And make sure you stay to the very end so you see the weirdest one we could find. So the first one is the urinals that they installed over in France. So in $75 fines and 2,000 officers just to try to stop people from urinating didn't solve the problem. Here's what they did. They installed urinals out in the public to try to keep men from just urinating everywhere. Now, somebody has to come in and clean it, so that's still an issue, but they realized that when they put these urinals out in public, people would use these instead of urinating everywhere. Well, they have that problem in France, but they talk about it like this happens all around the world. I'm sorry, I live in Dallas. I don't see a lot of people just urinating everywhere. And we don't have urinals installed on the side of the street. Funny thing is, in Paris, you can apparently walk down the street, there's a urinal right there, go, just go. Bad thing about it is, there's not any walls around anything. So when you're standing there relieving yourself, other people walk by and just, hey buddy, what's going on? So this one is kind of crazy. A German court ruling says men can stand to pee. Well, I can stand to pee sometimes, but you know, here's the deal. In Germany, they want you to sit down to urinate. They want you to sit down every time you urinate. The reason being, well, they say that it's much more sanitary. Well, I don't know. Maybe in Germany, they just get in and go whiz everywhere. Here in the United States, we try to aim for the spot in the back of the toilet. Well, that's why they should install fly stickers or something like that. Maybe a little bullseye. Pow. Wham. First try. In Germany, you used to have a sign there that says you have to sit down to urinate, and if you raise the lid, a loud voice would tell you, you're in trouble. Well, do you want to get a fine for standing to urinate? If not, go to France. You can urinate outside. You don't even have to go into the restroom. Kind of strange, but it is what it is. Okay, so of course Dubai holds another record. The highest toilet in the world. 154 floors up, and you can actually sit and look out the window. I think it's funny, you've got a toilet and a bidet so you can relieve yourself and really clean yourself right there while enjoying such a beautiful view from the 154th floor. Now this is kind of interesting too. When you have toilets that high, think about it, that's a long way down. What do you think happens when you flush a toilet? Toilet water, solids in there, can get going down at terminal velocity. That's right, terminal velocity for your fecal matter. Well, that can get up to 122 miles an hour for it coming down. Now, the problem is, if it hits the bottom like that, that could cause a problem. So what they do, about every 5 floors, they have to make an offset to keep things slowing down, not speeding up too fast. That's kind of a serious engineering problem. If you're a plumber, I've got to tell you, here in the United States, I've never been that high, but I've gone to poop before and thought it reached terminal velocity.
Here we go!
It is what it is. So then we got the largest bathroom in the world in China. Over 1,000 toilets. Now this is in a building that's 32,000 square feet and has 1,000 toilets. It means every 32 square feet, you've got a toilet. Now they've got it set up really nice too. It's not just your normal bathroom. They're spreading the culture, the toilet culture. You've got relaxing music. You have television. Anyway, the largest bathroom in the world, that's kind of crazy, but at least after you're there a while, you lose a little weight, see a movie, watch a television show, listen to good music, enjoy the rest of your day. Now, another one is one-way glass toilets. And not just toilets, public toilets. Now, I've seen something very similar to this before. There used to be a restaurant and there used to be an arcade area here in town. Now, actually, when you were at the urinal, there was a window in front of you and you can look out and see people eating their lunch, playing games, having fun, and you're sitting here taking care of business. Make sure to stay around till the end. We told you 8, but we found one after we put this together that is actually my favorite. And I think you're gonna love it, especially if you speak Japanese. So now we got pop-up street urinals and pop-up street toilets. Now think about this, guys, we're back over in Europe. So now they've got toilets that can just pop up out of the ground. Now the urinals can pop up in like a manhole type area. The toilets are a little bit bigger. But can you imagine like Bourbon Street, 6th Street in Austin, having these toilets that pop up right in the middle of the road and there's no traffic on them anyway. You've only got pedestrian traffic. Now there's a restroom that they can go to. This is actually a really good idea. Now, I'm not sure how the plumbing would work, going up and down. How do you adjust the pipe where it catches everything and whatnot? But that would be interesting to see. But can you imagine walking down the street to look for a restroom and you're like, well, wait, it was here last night. Well, now it's actually underground. And one thing about it, it's actually urinals for male and female. Now that's one I want to see. So next is the Mexican toilet, penthouse toilet, 15th floor that was built over an elevator shaft. That's right. Can you imagine sitting there and looking down at your feet and you can see down 15 floors? Now, that might scare the mess out of you. But if it doesn't, you just kind of sit there and look down and imagine what if. That's pretty wild. Can you imagine you got all your goodies exposed sitting there looking down thinking, wow. And then you got to stand up and walk across it to get to the paper or wash your hands. That can be kind of crazy. So in South Korea, you have the first toilet museum in the world. Now, as a plumber, I really can't wait to go. Well, not to the museum, I just can't wait to go. Okay, so a toilet museum. I've got to tell you, I've installed a lot of toilets, thrown away a lot of toilets, repaired a lot of toilets. Going to a toilet museum really does not impress me any. But the fact that it's in South Korea lets me know that I really don't have to worry about it. I will probably never go see it, but it's kind of neat to know that it's there. Now, the best Japanese toilet, this is cool. You actually have glass walls that go into an aquarium. So while you're in there, you've actually got fish swimming all around you. Now, I gotta tell you, I've watched them poop before because I'm a scuba diver, but to have them watch me, that's a little bit different. But this has got to be one of the most relaxing restrooms to be in. Can you imagine just sitting there and looking next to you and there's a barracuda or a shark or something like that? He's thinking, you're dinner, and you're just trying to get rid of yours. Kind of crazy. And the fact that you're sitting there taking care of business, looking around at fish, check you out like you're the invader. Well, actually, this time, you are. Anyway, what a great, relaxing way to go in and take care of business. If you're one of those people that normally take 3 to 5 minutes, can you imagine being in an aquarium? Might take 20 or 30. So I hope you enjoyed this. Have you got some weird plumbing facts or things that you think are really crazy that we didn't mention today? If so, do me a favor. Leave me a comment down below and let me know not only what was your favorite, but also what weird facts have you found that we should share with everybody else. Again, guys, this video was sponsored by The Trade Talks. This is our other YouTube channel. We have no videos up yet, but they are coming soon, and we're going to be talking about all the trades from all around the country. I'm Roger Wakefield, Lead AP, The Expert Plumber. I'll see you in the next video, if you don't get flushed.